So far in our example, we have only considered assets that the firm uses for its core businesses. In the coffee shop example, they were the furniture and the espresso machines. From now on, we will refer to these assets as operating assets. However, firms sometimes have assets they do not use in their core businesses. For example, a firm might hold cash or own stocks of other firms. We refer to these assets as non-operating assets. When we value a firm, we will separate assets into these two categories and we'll value each class of assets independently. The value of the operating assets will still be the present value of the free cash flows. The method we use to value the non-operating assets will depend on the specific type of asset. For example, the most common non-operating asset we will encounter is cash. Valuing it is really simple. The value of $100 is simply $100. Our market value balance sheet now looks like this. Since the two sides must equal, we have the following equation. The value of the operating assets plus the value of the non-operating assets must equal the value of debt plus the value of equity. If we are interested in the value of equity, we can solve this equation as follows. The value of equity equals to the value of operating assets plus the value of non-operating assets minus debt.